To understand why you need to run experiments at all, you have to learn an essential statistical concept, the correlation versus causation issue. Not so long ago, I read about an analysis in a, let's just say, not so high quality magazine. The research said that they collected data and they have statistical evidence that people who wear funny shirts frequently are more cheerful in their everyday life. The conclusion of the magazine was, if you wear funny shirts, you will be more cheerful too. But that's a wrong conclusion. Why? Because the original research discovered only correlation between wearing funny shirts and being cheerful. They said people who wear funny shirts frequently are more cheerful in their everyday life. But it didn't tell anything about which one is the cause and which one is the effect. That was only the arbitrary addition of the author of the article, which, well, might be wrong. Let's see the different possible cause-effect directions. One is that the author was right. Wearing funny shirts causes people to be more cheerful. But it's also possible that it's the other way around. Cheerful people, because they are cheerful, like to wear funny shirts. Sounds logical as well. And there is a third option. An outside reason causes both behaviors. For instance, the core personality of these people, which is the underlying reason of why they like funny shirts and why they are cheerful. But the two things are independent from each other. It's hard to tell which one is the truth, and often it's a combination of all three, but to say that it's the first one only and wearing funny shirts causes people to be cheerful, well, that's, at least, an unfounded conclusion. I want you to learn one thing from this. Correlation does not imply causation. Just because you know that people who wear funny shirts frequently are more cheerful in their everyday life, you cannot say that wearing funny shirts will make people cheerful. Here are a few more examples for the correlation versus causation issue. Have you ever heard that red cars get involved in more accidents than cars with any other colors? That's what statistics shows, and so some people draw the conclusion the color red is too vibrant and it makes people drive more aggressively. But isn't it also possible that more aggressive drivers choose red cars in the first place? There is a correlation between driving red cars and being involved in accidents, sure, but we don't know exactly what's the cause and what's the effect. Here is another example. Research says that people who graduated from university are more successful in their careers. There is a correlation. But are they successful because university prepared them for their job so well, or maybe there's an outside reason that these people have higher ambitions, higher working capacity, or sometimes simply just more money than others, and that caused both their graduation from university and success in their careers? The answer is, we do not know. We have statistical evidence only to prove the correlation, but we only suspect the cause-effect relationship. Correlation does not imply causation. And that's a problem for us, because in research, very often the real treasure lies in knowing more about causation. Okay, so what's common between the three examples I showed you? All of them analyzed historical data. They examined what happened in the past, they checked red cars getting involved in accidents in the past. They checked people's graduation from university and their career path by looking backwards to their track log. But analyzing historical data, by definition, is able to reveal correlations only. How do you discover causation then? I guess you know the answer. By using experiments. For instance, you take 10,000 random people, you give half of them red cars and the other half of them black cars, and you ask them to use those cars for a year. And after a year, you check how many of them were involved in car accidents. If you see that red cars in your experiment were involved in a significantly higher number of accidents, then you can finally conclude that color red is indeed a major factor in those accidents. By running an experiment, you can discover more than a correlation, you will see causation too. The take-home message from this video is this. Correlation does not imply causation, and by looking backwards, analyzing your historical data, most of the time you will only get correlation relationships. But you can discover real cause-effect relationships if you run experiments. See, running experiments is hard to do in the offline world, unless you have 10,000 cars to give random people just for the sake of research, but it's much easier to do that in online businesses. So let's see an example for that too.